Chipboard can be many things, a book or box for example, but today I'm concentrating on shapes that become the building blocks for your art. Elements on a journal page, in a mixed media collage, on a canvas, as the focal point of a card, the options are wide open. With that in mind, I'm really excited to introduce the newest Joggles products, laser cut chipboard, available in a variety of shapes and sizes. In today's video, I'll show you some of them, tell you about the basics of working with them, and share some samples. What you see here is a sampling of our initial release in January 2018. Chipboard is chipboard is chipboard. It all pretty much comes in this standard color. This has been primed with Dilutions white paint, and this has been done with the black. We'll talk about that in a second. But one of the things that I did want to mention, occasionally when you get something that's a fairly intricate cut like this, you might find that there's a piece, like on this fairy. See that piece right there? It didn't actually pop out. It's just a matter of pushing it through with something and then going ahead and removing it. Everything is cut. Occasionally the piece just doesn't release from the background. So no big deal there. I like to work on chipboard that's white, primarily because when I put white down first and then I put colors over the top, and let's just, actually, you know what, before I go too far. So these are standing silhouettes, three sizes, 5, 6, and 7. This is a dancing silhouette, again, 5, 6, and 7. Multiple sizes on the gears, multiple sizes on the branches. All right, so we said that. Let's slide this out of the way. One of the reasons that I like to prime with white first is because it makes all the difference in the world when it comes time to put color on. Now there's reason to use black, and we'll talk about that in a second. This is a piece of chipboard with the exact same colors on it as this in basically the same amounts. The only difference is that I put white Dilutions paint on here first. It does two things. First of all, it provides that white background so your colors stay truer. But unlike most paints, which is really nothing more than fine plastic in a suspension, the Dilutions paint and Distress also will allow sprays to not bead up and look all weird on here. So that's one of the reasons that I'm choosing Dilutions. If you want to use black, I'm just using the black marble. That's what I've done here and here on these gears. So when it comes time to think about working with these, there's pretty much a wide open assortment, and I'm going to show you a couple of samples that I've got going on. But first things first, let's just talk about quickly putting a coat of white on. So I'm just going to grab one of these standing figures. I've got some white paint here. I've got an ink blending tool that's already got some white on it. So all I'm going to do is just kind of get a coat on there and smush it around, and then I'm just going to lightly put a coat on. If you want more opaque coverage, because Dilutions is a semi-opaque paint, if you want more opaque coverage, it's just a matter of putting this first thin coat on, then giving it a moment and letting it dry. And it honestly, it doesn't take all that long. It's no big deal. So when you think about what you want to do, then of course we think about black. So let's just put a little bit more white on that piece, slide it out of the way. When we talk about black, now the sky really is the limit because, and let's get this wiped up, now you've provided a very dark background, and the thing about that is things like glimmer polish, any kind of stickles will work really well on there except for something that's really dark, and then the glitter kiss. So this is one of the small crowns. And you can see that I painted it black, and then I just highlighted it so ever so lightly with the glitter kiss, but it makes a huge difference. And, you know, crowns that perch on birds' heads or on people's heads is really a fun kind of thing. So when you're ready, and let me actually show you another example. So this is a sample that I did. This is one of the women. I think this is the 6-inch size. She's got a coat of white Dilutions paint on top, and then I used a couple of colors of gilding polish that I went ahead and just very lightly smudged on. I put the light color on first, then I put the darker one, then I came back with the white just to tone it down if I thought it had gotten a bit too, I don't know, heavy. It wasn't exactly giving me the look that I was aiming for. So when it comes time to do this, I'm going to, let's just use some of this. So I'm going to snap my applicator out. Now I didn't wash this the last time I put it away, which is probably a bad move on my part. You know what, since this is a gear, let's go ahead and use gold. We'll go slightly more realistic. So here's some gold glitter polish, glitter kiss. So all I'm going to do is slide it across the edge of the jar like that, load a little bit on. Sometimes I do that, and it's just a matter of applying a really light touch like this and getting it here and there on there. Super simple to do. Now, conversely, if instead you would rather, let's wipe this up, you would rather use something like the gilding polish, then you can certainly do that too. Same process, built-in applicator, so you're going to get pretty much the same results in terms of the application method. So this is Indian pink. Snap that out. I'm going to grab a little bit on here, smush it around. Now I get a very different look here than I did on that figure, that dancing figure, because I did that on top of white. But you can see how easy it is. Let me catch right there and then let me hold this up for you. You can see how easy it is. If I want to put a completely, not solid layer, but if I want to cover all the areas, I can do that too, but you don't have to. Let's slide this out of, whoops, slide this out of the way for 1 second. You can use a variety of different things. This is chipboard. It's 60 point, I think, so it's sturdy. This is some of the fantasy paint from Pebbio. This is a mixture of prism and moon. Someplace else here, oh, so here's another piece. This is one of the bird cages that I did with the prism. So I get a very different look. I guess what I don't want to do is give you the idea that all you can do is use regular paints, because here's one of the branches, and this is one of the vitre colors that happens to be opaque, so it's not completely transparent, which is why it works really well on this branch. As I said a moment ago, we have lots of different shapes, figures, all kinds of fun things that you can work with. And then the one that I'm really excited about are these puzzles. So we have a 5-inch, 6-inch, and 7-inch square puzzle. The one that you see here has squared corners. We'll also have an option where the corners are rounded off. This stuff is so new, I haven't even had a chance to play with it yet. But let's just imagine for a second that you've got color on here, you've got pattern on here, and now you want to start breaking these up. So you could do something like take one piece off and let that be separate. You could write something on there. You can take these three pieces off and have them be separate. Now I'm a little bit limited because I'm only on, this is one of our disc-bound watercolor journals pages that just pop right in and out, and this is only a 6x6 page, so I don't have a ton of room to work. But you can see the possibilities. You could break this whole thing up if you wanted and not interlock the puzzle pieces. So there's options galore when it comes time to think about how to use these. So for example, is something like this. Now you do not have to be able to draw to do this. If you can put black paint on one of these, then you can do this. And then it's just a matter of grabbing. This is a metallic jelly roll pen. I use the same color that I did here on the background, kind of all pulls it together, gives it that same look and feel, and then I just lettered it. No big deal, very simple to do. When you think about art journal pages, of course the sky really is the limit. So here's one of our frames. We have them in three different shapes. This one just kind of fits. I didn't make this page with this shape in mind, but it just kind of fits in there. If I wanted to, I could turn it horizontally up here. I showed you the bird with the crown a few minutes ago. So again, it doesn't have to be great art that you're making. You're just making things that make you happy and that you enjoy working with. I've come back to this dancing figure that I showed you a few minutes ago. It couldn't be any simpler to get the color on here, and then it's just a question of going ahead and putting her on a page. Now this is kind of all mostly flat stuff, but then it comes time to think about what about if you want to work with something a little bit more 3D. So what I've got here, this is one of our chipboard shapes. It is in fact, I'm sorry, frames. It's this. I have one of the larger gears from the large set. Someplace in here, what can I say? There's a small piece here and here from the small set. This is another one of the large ones. You can see that you can start incorporating these into a variety of different projects. They become layers, and sometimes what you're looking to do is build layers. And when you're talking about chipboard shapes, building layers becomes really easy.